All right, Caster, you ready?
Wait, you ready? I'm in with them.
All right, I'm in too.
I boned him.
That's it.
I'm in.
Hey.
I still hold him.
Shorty like a $1,000 plate, fine china. Tell her that she beautiful every day, I remind her. And I jump in a pussy like a lake, I'm a diver. And the last man was a pussy had a vagina.
Hey yo, what's poppin', ladies and gentlemen? Flush the Aim Lock here, back with another banger on Viper MC on The Infernal Realm. In today's video, guys, is gonna be me teaching you how to frickin' base raid. I'll be showing you guys what loadouts to take, and be showing you guys how we base raid, what we think whenever we're in bases. I'm gonna put you guys in the head of Flusha Aimlock while he's base raiding. So I think you guys are gonna have a great time watching. Hopefully, you know, maybe you guys get a little bit more of an idea of how I base raid and like what I'm thinking when I'm in base and all that stuff. So I'm sure you guys are gonna have a great time watching, and let's aim for 30 likes on today's freaking episode. And guys, like literally at the moment we are so close to 750 subscribers. I think we're like literally 10 away. So if you guys could just go down there and hit the subscribe button, it would mean literally the world to me. With that all being said, hope you guys have a wonderful day or night, and I'll see you in the video. Peace out. Enjoy, everyone.
Last time on Dragon Ball Z.
Dude, what was the point of that? I don't understand. There literally is a whole gang on me now. Idea. I fucking got him! No, I'm boned!
Well, tell me if you're getting
attacked. Dude, I just trapped all of them. Quick him. Nice. Okay, killed one.
Okay, three. Oh,
no, killed him. Alright, boys, after that clip where we freaking killed a 7 man, we took them out, boys. I don't know why they were trying to cam me as a solo, but we freaking got them, everyone. We freaking took them out live on camera. So, I'm gonna show you guys what we have after that. We have 4 sets in each of these chests, and we've also got a lot of pearls. As you guys can see, I can do my stats really quick. A lot of the deaths are just from going 1 DTR, but I only have 1 actual real death, so my KD is doing pretty good right now. This is our partner Iams chest, and in this clip right here, guys, I just want to explain to you what like loadout you're going to need for base raiding and what we're about to go do for base raiding. And while I'm in the base, I'm going to be explaining what I'm doing and all that stuff, just so you guys can understand better how to base raid. So your loadout is like the most important part that you're going to have while you're base raiding. Whenever I'm running into base, I always make sure to take a bone if I have one, a strength 2 item, an item to prevent them from like moving around and stuff. I always like having 2 blocks that will make them have trouble blocking up, which in this case is going to be my Avery Starvation Flesh and a Measly Bone. And then I also like having partner items that can get me out of 1x1s and in 1x1s. So these partner items would be a Snowball and a Heifu Time Warp. So if you're in a 1x1, you can time warp out of it if you pearl in a corner or something, or if they 1x1 themselves, you can time warp in with them if you pearl in a corner. And if you're in a 1x1 and they try to like slab you off or something, you can use a Snowball to get in the 1x1 with them by snowballing them, pearling in, which I'm sure you guys have seen before from like Heifu, Mezoid on my channel, if you guys have seen it, I've done it a lot, and other YouTubers like that. So then those two are very important. And then the logger baits is like for, you never know what can happen, but sometimes they'll have like their drop downs messed up, and you can like put the logger bait down on their pressure plate. Like for example, in here, if I put a logger bait on this pressure plate, you'd be able to pearl into here, but in our base, it wouldn't do much. So then one string 2 item at least. You guys always need to have a string 2 item if possible, if not more than that. So that's why I'm taking a rage break, because if you get into a small area with them and you need that string 2 for a few seconds, then they will usually like get really low and either panic, or you can quick drop and make them raidable with that. So like I said, your loadout is very important. You guys always want to have crapples. In our case, we're not very loaded on crapples, so I'm actually gonna store some. I didn't mean to have that many on me. So I like having at least like 10 crapples on me. I usually like having. So those are very important as well. And yeah, obviously, you know, you wanna have a full P2 set, speed set if possible, and a stack of pearls. So that's pretty much how I choose what load I'm gonna take, and always a pickaxe is important. If you guys can bring a minor pickaxe, those help a lot and do go a long ways, but we only have one left, and I'm letting Caster use one, and I'm gonna use an E5 just for the sake of it. So yep, that's basically all you need for the loadout, and I'll bring us back whenever we're at a base. Okay, boys, the next thing I actually want to show you that I forgot to mention is how you're gonna want to look for a faction. And you're gonna do this by doing such F-lists. I usually like to do F-list 10, so many pages there are, because 10 is like a midway point usually. So I like just scrolling up, and you see right above this person's faction name, Blues, it'll show their DTR, or like it'll show like 3.25 or 5.50. And you're always gonna want to look for the ones that are in yellow and say 0.01 or like 0.25 or something like that.
So this basically means that they are one death until they can go raidable. So if you kill them one time, they go raidable. So like if you click on that name, you'll see Shan Shido. I don't know what that means. 1, 2, 3. But then you can basically look for that guy, and if he looks like someone that you would want to run in, then you could F focus him by doing such F focus his IGN, and then boom, he's focused. But if you don't like the faction that you find, you can do such F list 11 usually, and look, keep him going. If there's no one there, you can F list 12. Let's see, there's a guy right here, 5x5, and the OG bear. So say you like this guy right here, I want to run to his base. You can do like that, and you can focus him, and then you can run over. And another thing is, a lot of people do advertise in chat. So let me look. Letting in P1 sharp 1212 DTR. So you're usually gonna want to look for 1 DTR bases, and like this guy right here, letting in 1 DTR 3 high rich AF, letting in drop if you don't scum. So this guy right here, what I like to look for in bases as well if I'm going solo is that they can't log bait. So basically that means if they like logs, if you run in and they're solo but then they log on another faction member, and basically that can screw you over a lot. So basically if you run into a base and they log on a bar, then it's very hard to make them raidable unless you have like a lot of partner items and you get very lucky or they make a mistake or something or quick drop. So something that you can see with this guy right here is that he cannot log on a bar because he's on DTR freeze, which is what you'll see right here, time until region 21 minutes and 3 seconds. And then he also has no one else in his faction except for him. So that means that it's impossible for him to log on another member unless he allies with them, which in that case is bannable. So yeah, that's basically how I like choosing what bases I go to. So that's just something I thought I'd mention really quickly. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the base rating clips.
Okay, I'm at the base right now, Caster. It's interesting to say the least.
Okay. Interesting. Oh, whoa.
Oh, he's outside the base right now. Wait,
he's holding
us.
He's outside. Pod.
Yeah, I'm fighting him right now, dude. He's outside the base, like, holding speed pots and crap. He's really bad.
Man.
Yeah, dude, if you can get here fast, like, we might be able to quickie him outside, dude.
I think I'm like...
His gates are wide open right now.
I'm almost... here. No!
I think it's...
Run in!
Oh my god, we're in. Oh, it's an eye make.
Yeah, it's a giant eye make. But okay, it's still open.
I think the move might be to like actually go down his eye make, because if he does have a bard that he's baiting, like his
bard. Wait for the bard to log on first. Stamp, you want to stand like in here?
Mm-hmm. I'll like break wall up from it, and then you can just like do that, okay?
Actually, if I stand right here, but he can hit me out.
Then stand like here.
I wonder what he's going to do. I'm
very curious as well.
Oh. You gonna go to shut it? Oh, wait. Just block it off so he can't shut it. Wait.
Oh, dude.
I wanna explain. All right, guys. So we're gonna try to hit him into a corner so we can pre-pro in that corner and we can. Oh, there you go. No, he blocked that off. So he's gonna get on his
eye make. Okay, guys. So we're gonna wait and see if his bard logs on. And if his bard doesn't log on, I think the move would be to just pre-pro into a 1x1. All right, Caster. We're both gonna go into a corner, guys. And we're gonna throw an Ender Pearl at the wall. So whenever he comes up, we can use our Heifu Time Warp and get into a 1x1 with him. All right.
Oh, he blocked off the corner. I would have time warped in. That's weird.
This guy's weird. He's a mad.
He's not logging on a bard, though. He's not logging on a bard.
Oh, no.
Wait. Reprawl that corner.
Well, I already did.
Okay. Oh, he's going to go down the drop down. Oh,
he's
trying
to snowball you. Holy crap. Okay, so what the plan could be here is that we each just go down the drop down, because it looks like he already knows that we're trying to pre-pearl.
Doesn't mean he's not going to fall for it still.
What if we pre-pro on like a random spot in the base?
You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking right here. He might just go like right here and go up here. I'm thinking this block right here. It might be it. Oh, wait. Oh, tell me if we pre-pro in that corner.
Dude, look at this guy. Like, he knows.
Yeah, he knows, but just because he knows doesn't mean he's going to stop it.
Just because I think that we might be able to just bait him by like going at like a really awkward spot.
Wait, his upside might start going outside. What is he doing?
No, it didn't.
It might start. No. Cause look what he's doing. It's like right here or something. It's like right here in the middle.
I'm gonna go out long then, just so I can be ready. Please block up there.
Oh, he's just invis. Oh, okay. For a second, I thought he had a bard.
Yeah,
I don't know what he's doing. I think he's terrified of us.
I know. I'd be pretty scared of balls.
Balls of my mace and 420 Minecraft, the best duo in HCF, they call them.
Oh my god.
They call him terrifying. Like,
oh, he just pre-pearled. Wait, I heard him.
Did he really? Oh, that might have been me.
Oh, that might have been you actually.
Yeah.
What is this guy doing? He's literally getting smoked right now. No cap.
I'm in with you.
Good stuff. Oh, this guy.
Okay, pearl down.
I'm gonna pearl into that corner.
I don't know.
What we could do, I'm gonna guess, because he's already got like a good area right here. He's basically got like this area where it'd be super easy to one by one himself. So I think I'm just gonna go into that corner and push him towards it.
I'm ready to break myself. Wait.
Dude, let him go. I'm in
one.
Let's go. I'm not letting
him mine
out.
I'm not letting him mine out. There we go. Yeah, I'm not letting him mine out.
I'm gonna boat him. I'm gonna boat him and then time warp next. Oh no. Or not time warp, rage break. Dude, he fucking, what's it called?
I'm trying to bone him.
Bone him, please.
I think I boned him. Nice. I don't know what happened. No, I didn't bone him, actually. I didn't bone him, but I'm chasing chase down.
Going south. What is this drop down, dude? No, you gotta bone him, dude.
Oh, I gotta bone him. No, dude, wait. He doesn't have a crit out area.
Wait, Caster, can we cross pearl through this?
Yeah, we can pearl straight down. Dude. We can just pearl straight down. He doesn't know it. Don't show him yet.
If you guys look, there are walls right here, so whenever we pearl down, it'll just put us through the walls rather than,
Yeah. But you can't stand back. You have to, like, hug it and pearl. All
right, Caster, you ready?
I don't want to do it.
Should we both go in and logger bait and kill our loggers?
Because I think we get banned from pearl glitching. Wait, you ready? I'm in with them.
All right, I'm in too.
I boned him.
Nice,
let's go.
Nice, bro. I wish I had a pot counter here. All right, Caster, can you stay way over there. You stay way over there. I'm going to get my bone out here.
Okay. Yeah, you start boning him. You should be off in, like 3 seconds. I'm going to combo him at least myself.
Move. And you get hits. He's boned.
There you go. I'm gonna have strength two. I'm gonna have a ton of strength two in about 3 seconds, dude, because I use the combo ability.
I'm gonna rage break next, so we can get strength two. I'm gonna rage break.
I'm not hitting him at all, dude. All
right, a rage break.
Irritable. Oh my gosh, dude. Let's go, dude. That was really good of us. Okay.
He had no sets though.
Oh, he had P1. Really? Wow. Honestly, that guy played really well to the point where I thought he might have been. I thought he was P2. He had snowballs though. Partner items for days.
Oh wait, that's actually.
He had
really
bro
nice.
Invis. Yeah, this is really good.
Okay, so
this is why you base raid, guys. This is why you don't trap. You guys can get really loaded from these kind of things. Boys.
Need wood. Oh, they got mans here. Steel armor raid, dude. Run.
Okay.
They got many guys here. I'm gonna die caster with all the fucking partner items, dude. I have no pots.
Dude, wait. Are you serious, dude? Hello. What are you doing? Wait, who is this guy?
I need pots.
Dude, there's pots on the ground.
I got some. It's good.
Okay, alright, we can fight this guy.
I'm gonna Avery Starvation flush him. It's curse you. Oh, this is a big faction, I think. It's a two-man.
No, it's two. We can just win this. Let's just win this then.
Dude, but I'm super drained on pots.
There's pots in the drop down over here. Oh, I got starved. Over here. Yeah, in that area. There's a ton of pots on the ground.
Alright.
If you want, we can try to start escaping then. Yeah, I'm gonna try to make my escape. I don't have pots on me. He aggro pulled on me. This is good. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna get out.
Jesus Christ. Wait. Trying to make my great escape right now.
Yeah, you gotta make your escape. I didn't get a lot of the partner
items. No, I'm dead and I have all the partner items on me.
Are you serious?
Wait, these guys blow. I might be able to do something.
You made better escapes before in the past.
I'm pearling up. Oh yeah, these guys blow. I'm good. Wait.
Oh, I can give you a bro invis.
No, it's good.
Wait, I'm gonna drop you a bro invis. Take the bro invis and use it. Use the bro invis. Okay. That too.
Alright, I'm gonna completely block this off and go into here. Right. Okay, and I should be out, dude. I got a stack of snowballs.
I know, we gotta get out of here. Alright, I'm running back to our base. Yeah,
I'm gonna try to freaking dip, boys. Sadly, we did lose a little bit of the glowstone because I throw it out. I had to throw out a lot of glowstone so I could actually carry pots, but it's okay. Yeah, that was really good. I'm happy that we were
able to. This just goes to show that people steal raids regardless of whether or not you're a YouTuber or a random player. So you should always be prepared to deal with people who are just going there just to take free stuff.
Alright. Hey boys, this is all the loot that we got from the raid right here. As you can see, they did have a lot of loot. They had 16 snowballs, some time warps, some pearls, some switch sticks, which we really need, and freaking 31 Avery Starvation Flesh, and a lot of brewing materials, which is all going to be absolutely huge for us because we don't have a ton of stuff. So I'm going to get a quick refill on pearls, and
as you guys can see, we did get really loaded from all that. So GG's to those guys. That is literally going to help so freaking much. Wait, caster, come here. These guys might actually have you because they were on for one of the kiosks. Here, I'm gonna snowball them out, okay?
Wait, you want me to bone him then?
Yeah, no, don't. Say snowball him out.
I didn't get in. I pearl then.
Okay, nice. Let's just stick this guy right here, dude.
He blocks up with wood, bro. This was not a good decision. You stand over there?
Yeah, I got the side. It's all gooch. I know.
He instantly shuts it.
I'm in.
There you go.
I'm in.
Hey, one of them. All right.
Okay, I'm gonna starve. I starved them. Okay, can you make sure?
He can't get out. He literally can't mine it. If he mines out, he either mines outside to the kid outside, or he mines to us. So you got him basically.
I'll build myself.
Okay.
I'm sticking him right now. I should get strength to very soon though. Oh yeah, I'm not trying to like right now. Okay, I have it for 12 seconds.
I pulled them with you. Nice.
Okay, each of us get one side. Each of us get.
There you go. Boom. Let's go, dude.
Let's go.
Is he P1? He was P1.
Dude, he had nothing. This guy was one for kiosks. How did he have nothing?
Dude, I honestly thought coming to here, this guy would have stuff, dude.
I know what.
I literally saw him
at his base, like AFKing for about 8.
Dude,
kills.
We terrorized a poor man for nothing.
Terrorized a poor man. That's all I accomplished here, and I'm happy. GG's to that guy.
Boys, we're pulling up to solo gang here. I think Flush is already there. I think the plan we're gonna do here is I'm gonna try to bro invis and full invis. If you guys didn't know, right clicking bro invis will make me full invis, but I get to keep my armor on. Okay, you want me to?
Yeah. Okay, then draw me the extra bro invis.
You get in as well, right?
Okay. He's looking. What the fuck? Dude, he just
what is he looking at?
I don't know. He just like swung his sword in the air.
Let me slash sounds real fast. What is this guy messaging me?
I'm so scared. I think this guy's a trap. Let me in, bro.
Oh!
I knew it, dude.
F humming.
Okay, go for it, bro. I can snowball him right now, caster.
Do it. I'll be able to get him with him and bone him.
Okay.
Oh, what? He just pulled into the wrong block. You want, what's it called? The set's kind of more important. You want me to come back and then just pick up the set?
Yeah, sure.
If you can't do anything, he's just going to crit you out. How long can you stay alive?
I don't know. Cool it, bro. Okay.
I'm 300 away.
Okay. Chill, dude. Bro.
How many pots do you have left? I'm going to start pearling. Because I want to get the set.
I have one pot, though.
Okay, I'm 34, 34, 34, 20. Drop a set, just drop it and it'll go outside.
Did you get it?
No, I didn't. I got the sword. You need to bring 2 time warps so you can drop me one.
I did. If we just stay down, dude, what's he gonna do? Because he's gonna go up and then be trapped.
No, it's like a too high area. He's just gonna like wait, he's just gonna keep going around. There's another guy here.
Okay, what I'm thinking, caster, is whenever we run in, we should bone him instantly, go up the upside to follow him.
Oh yeah.
And then while he's boned, we can time warp in a corner and just push him to it.
Yeah.
That could be the move.
We have to pearl into the base though. That's the problem because he's just going to pull the stupid trap.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
Is this area 3 high right here or 2?
The bottom base is 3 high, yeah. We kind of both have to time this right. Just stand back. Okay, it doesn't work. Because if it does...
Oh, fuck.
Wait, what?
He like.
What was that?
He looked at it, I thought he was opening it. Okay, you ready?
Oh, you didn't get in. Oh, you're so lucky.
Nice trap.
Wait, his trap's not gonna work now. Wait, yeah, this trap is stuck. He's gotta fix his trap now.
That was, he thinks I was being serious when I said nice trap.
He said thank you?
Yeah,
that's kinda wholesome. Oh, by the way, over here, I noticed down here, we actually can snowball him out at a certain spot if he stands on the bottom part of his base down here. See? I snowballed him! I'm keeping him in this gank. I'm gonna take out my bones. I'm gonna bone him. I boned him. Oh my god.
Please, caster.
He's kind of rateable. Are you out?
No, like, I'm in his full fucking base right now. Come on, caster, dude.
No, dude. No. I killed him. Oh, my God. Nice. I killed him. Oh, my gosh, dude. I'm so proud of myself, dude.
I am so happy, dude. Let's fucking go. No, you're dying, Johnny boy.
I know, dude. That kid was being so freaking weird about the whole thing, dude. I'm so glad that guy just went right away right there.
He messaged me gay FAG.
Guy's stealing raid.
Alright, well,
was there anything here worth?
We got two sets.
Two sets? I will take two sets.
Like, I didn't know about it the first time, but like, dude, he messaged me. Oh my god.
Yeah, the guy's probably furious, but you know what? It took forever, but you know what? We ended up doing what we want. By the way, there's a random faction that is starting to chase me for literally no reason.
Well, dude, I'm getting my revenge and goofing his base a little bit.
Okay, you know, we could just straight up fight these guys. Come out here and straight up fight. They're only two. They're two. Okay. They're only two. We can just straight up fight.
Should I rage ability or combo ability?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, I'm gonna rage. I'm gonna not rage. Rage brick. So I have strength two.
Keep in mind, I have three pots right now, dude.
Wait, there's pot refill in the auto brewer. Why didn't you get a pot refill?
Oh, I had no clue. Oh, dude, Gnarl's about a quick drop though.
I'm gonna take out a
quickie Gnarl. Quickie Gnarl.
I might just get into a 1v1. Oh my god, wait, no.
I'm on him.
Oh, I have an invis block here, dude. In my face, dude. I can't get to you. That's there good, you go. Good. Wait, I'm gonna block. Wait, oh, nope.
Go in.
Block me into 1v1. Block me into 1v1. There we go. Let's go.
Okay, I'm gonna mine down really quickly and grind him out with you, okay?
Okay. I'm not gonna combo build or anything. I don't think I need to.
We're both hitting.
Oh, I'm gonna pot. I have to pot. Okay, yeah, there we go.
I'm getting like constant hits on him, too. He just hit me, dude. What the fuck?
Alright, there we go. I'm gonna stay right here. Okay, there we go.
Yeah, he's dead for all sure, right. Dude. Got him.
There we go. Let's go. Nice, dude. Those are two free sets, though.
I mean, yeah. That was worth it.
Dude,
I mean,
what were they trying?
Okay, boys. Sadly, that is going to be the freaking end of the video. I hope you did all enjoy, though, the third episode of How To HCF. The rest of the series will be absolute bangers after bangers after bangers. And guys, just comment down below what you guys want me to teach you how to do. And, you know, just what you guys want to see in the How to HCF series. If you guys do have any ideas, I'm planning on just doing a lot of base raiding and trapping this map and just showing you guys how I play the game, how to get rich, and, you know, just overall, like, what the best tactics are. So, I can show you guys what we have right now sets-wise. These are all of our sets at the moment. We have about a row of each piece. And this is all from, like, stuff that happened that you guys will see in next episode as well as this episode. I can't really show you our partner items chest right now because one of our faction members, I believe three words or caster, logged out with all the partner items just for whenever I was 1DTR trapping, because, you know, he didn't want to lose all the partner items if I did go raidable. But from 1DTR trapping, this is what we ended up getting partner item wise but we do have a lot more than that. Like, I can show you guys, like, we have a few sacks of snowballs, lots of time warps, some switch sticks, potion counters, all that stuff. So that's not even a fourth of the partner items that we've got, guys. Like, caster logged out with a full inventory of partner items and a full inventory of sets. So whenever he logs back on tomorrow and in the next episode, I'm gonna show you guys an updated clip of like all of our loot that we have, but I don't think I'll be able to show you guys this episode. But sets wise basically just know that we have about this plus maybe like two more and a little bit more pearls. But overall, we're doing so good right now in this How to HCF series. We are getting pretty rich, and I say for a no rank, I think we're doing really nicely. So hope you did all enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out, everyone.